The reality of mobile networking means that the number of file requests can be just as significant as the size of requests. In other words, aim to reduce the number of image requests, not just the size of image files.
We call this problem latency, which is the delay between request and response.
Yeah, every time your browser attempts to retrieve an image from a website, there are potential delays at every step of the way between your device and the website's servers. And every one of those delays can vary significantly and unpredictably.
Behind all that is the fundamental problem that data can't travel any faster than the speed of light.
Yeah, I mean, surely Google or someone else could do something about that. The speed of light, you know, it's so last century. Cameron, like, you're
stop,
a physicist,
stop, stop,
right?
Stop. No. Okay. Definitely not, at least not anytime this millennium.
All right, whatever. Anyway, optical fiber can only achieve a bit better than half the speed of light. So, at best, London to California return trip times, for example, are around 100 milliseconds.
And performance expert Ilya Grigorik calls latency the new bottleneck.
Thanks, Sam. Indeed, it turns out that for many modern web pages, bandwidth doesn't matter as much as latency does. If you find that surprising, check the instructor notes for an explanation of why that is the case. The bottom line is that performance is a fundamental part of a truly responsive design. In practice, that means you need to reduce the file sizes and reduce the number of file requests. And one great way to reduce the number of image bytes is to compress them or reduce the number of images.
Thanks, Ilya. In this lesson, we show you lots of ways to achieve graphical effects without image files.